Welcome back to another week of anticipation here at Discovery. I'm Shyla, doing this news for the last time. And Leah, Mario, and Jade will be joining us in for a bit. And Emma, too. This is the Discovery School News. Last episode.
Shyla.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please pause for a moment of silence.
Here are the announcement for the week of May 22nd through May 25th. A reminder to all students, Wednesday will be a full day and Thursday will be an early release day with the school day ending at 11:30. Thank you.
Don't right, go up to, don't tell them not to go up to them like that or to him like that. He'll get mad.
Don't worry about it. You want him mad?
I don't want him mad. I really don't want him mad.
He'll be fine.
We are following up on a controversial story involving one of our 8th grade teachers here at Discovery who is refusing to be interviewed by our news team. We understand he's in his room right now. Let's catch up with our team who is just outside his room right now.
Thanks, guys. We're gathered here outside of the teacher's lounge, hoping to confront Mr. Duell and get to the bottom of why he is refusing to be interviewed by us. Here he is. Let's go. Mr. Duell, why are you hiding?
Mr. Duell, is it really true you never smile?
Never.
Is it true, Mr. Duell? Can Matt solve all problems?
Mr. Duell, why are you not granting us an interview?
Mr. Duell.
We're interviewing right now.
Is it true that the
room is... Mr. Duell, why do genies only grant 3 wishes?
Why can't you on toast?
Is it true that you eat mayonnaise straight out of the jar?
Never. Almost. He's throwing it.
Is it true that you wear tiny... Is it true that you wear wooden shoes?
Wooden shoes? I don't know what that means.
Is it true you never smile at home?
I smile every day at home.
Mr. Duell, a man of mystery, or a man hiding something. Back to you in the studio. It's time to play our little guessing game titled Fact or Fiction. Wait! Yeah. For the last time. But we're gonna give you 3 statements and you're gonna have to guess whether they're fact or fiction. You have to guess out loud. It doesn't count if you do not say it out loud, you big cheater.
Don't cheat, don't cheat.
These are the last time that the cheaters are gonna cheat. Okay. Since summer vacation has passed upon us, we thought we would provide you 3 summer-related questions. Without further ado, number 1, fact or fiction. The sun in the summer is closer to Earth, which makes it warmer. Fact or fiction?
Fiction.
Sun is closer in the
fiction,
summer.
It just gets hotter.
Fiction.
That has to be a fact because you get hotter.
Okay, this is fiction, Scarlet. Many people believe that the temperature changes because the Earth is closer to the sun in the summer and farther from the sun in the winter. In fact, the Earth is farthest from the sun in July and is closest to the sun in January. During the summer, the sun's rays hit the Earth at a steep angle. The light does not spread out as much, thus increasing the amount of energy hitting any given spot. Also, the long daylight hours allow the Earth plenty of time to reach warm temperatures. Number 2, fact or fiction. Dragonflies do headstands to turn their body away from the sun to cool off during the summer.
Fact.
This is a fact, Scarlet. You may have seen dragonflies in a handstand-like pose, looking like gymnasts in training. That is the obelisk's posture. The dragonfly lifts its abdomen until its tip points to the sun. thereby minimizing the amount of surface area exposed to solar radiation. Number three, fact or fiction. The watermelon, a summertime favorite, is a vegetable.
Fiction, it has seeds.
Okay, this is indeed a fact, Jade Emma. Watermelons are one of the most popular food items during the summer months. There are a total of 30 different types of watermelons. In truth, watermelons are not even fruits, but vegetables, belonging to the cucumber family. Watermelon consists of around 92% water. An average American consumes about 15 pounds of watermelon in a year.
Stinger time. This is unfortunately the last one of the year, but we will continue them next year. In kindergarten, Louise and Miss B in first grade, Angeliana and Miss Reyes in second grade, Hajar and Miss Whiting, third grade, Renata and Miss G in fourth grade, Jasmine and Miss Lyons, fifth grade, Yen and Miss B in sixth grade, Leslie and Miss Ianos in seventh grade, Jody and Mr. Balder, and in eighth grade, Aaron and Mr. Dole. If you heard your name, see Miss Smith in the office to receive your mass-produced product of perfection.
Birthdays, here are the birthdays of the week. On Monday, Josiah Pfeiffer celebrates his birthday. On Tuesday, Allison Martinez has a birthday. On Wednesday, Gianna Alcala, Natalia Sandoval, David Delator, Devaney Delator celebrate their birthdays. And on Friday, Anthony Canez, Justin Nim, Aubriana Esquivel, Yetsiri Ramirez Venezuela, and Kaitin Payan Martinez celebrate their birthdays. Happy birthday, everyone.
It is live, go.
For the Scorpion of the Week, Emma got a chance to catch up with another success story here at Discovery. Emma?
Thanks, guys. We're here on the computer lab to recognize Joaquin for winning the Perseverance Award at the last award ceremony. Thanks for taking the time to speak with us today.
I'm glad to be here.
Thank you. The 8th grade team wanted to recognize you for your hard work and winning the Perseverance Award at the last award ceremony. Would you mind explaining what perseverance means to you?
I've been working really hard and I try my best. I try my best at school and I worked really hard.
Good. What has been your favorite part of being in 8th grade?
Doing all the work in classes and being with my friends.
Cool. What is the most difficult part of being in 8th grade?
Math and reading. Those are the hardest class of all time. I tried to work and I tried my best. I got good grades too.
Mine's math. Can you give any advice to any students moving up to 7th and 8th grade?
Do the work and get good grades and try their best and do all the hard work.
Mm-hmm. Thanks again, Joaquin, for your outstanding work in 8th grade this year and this good luck in high school. And one more thing. We heard that you had a really good Mario impression. Can you do it for us, please?
Sure.
Okay. Woohoo! Cool, that was good. Back to you in the studio.
Nice interview, but that is unfortunately the last bit of news for this year. And as you know, this is my last show, as I am heading to high school next year. I want to thank everyone for the memories, and I hope to see some of you soon. I will miss you all. Remember, we're a Discovery. Feel the sting. Where the G stands for, gonna be a great summer.
Bye!
Squeeze. Some people wind up.